Welcome back, everybody. My next guest tonight is a professor of physics and mathematics at Columbia University. He's also the founder of the World Science Festival, happening next week right here in New York City. Please welcome our friend, Brian Greene. Brian, it's always fun to talk to you. Last time you were here, you were talking about gravitational waves, the discovery, finally, of bending of the space, the fabric of space-time.
Yes.
And what are we excited about science-wise tonight? What are
well,
you explaining?
Yeah, tonight we are basically the one-year anniversary of an amazing discovery in astronomy, the most powerful exploding star, the most powerful supernova ever detected in human history.
Okay, so what is a supernova, first of all?
A supernova is an exploding star, and the one that was found is 570 billion times brighter than the sun at its peak luminosity. Just imagine that. A point of light in the sky, half a billion times, you know, 500 billion times more powerful than the sun.
Okay, and when did this happen?
Well, it happened 3.8 billion years ago. But it was discovered 1 year ago. It's funny how it works, time.
It is. Because it's 3.8 billion light years away.
That's
is that
right.
the idea?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. No, but did we see a flash of light? If it's that bright,
yes.
Why didn't I look up, you know, at night and just see the sky just completely blotted out by a supernova?
Yeah, well, if it was close enough to us, you would have. In fact, if this supernova happened, say, at the distance of Pluto, it would have wiped everything out. We would all be gone. So it's kind of good that it happened 3.8 billion light years away.
Sure, sure. Why was it so huge? Hypernova.
Hypernova, yeah. So
what causes one?
Let's look at a star before it explodes, right?
Okay.
To get a sense of how this all does. You can bring it up on the screen here.
Okay.
So if we dive into a star, right, we penetrate, say, into the surface, and we go deeper layer by layer. Ultimately, we get to the star's core, right?
Okay.
And the core, because of its enormous temperature, tens of millions of degrees, is actually a nuclear furnace where simple atoms fuse together to build the more complicated ones, like the ones needed for life. And the thing is, as these atoms fuse, they give off energy, and that energy streams outward, and it props the star up. That's how the star supports its own weight. And this is vital because sooner or later, a star uses up all its nuclear fuel. No more fusion, no more outward flowing energy. And of course, then what happens is the star will collapse in on itself. Matter rushes in and rebounds like a ball bouncing off a very stiff surface, sends a shockwave going through the star, ripples outward layer by layer, and the star explodes.
So it collapses in and then bursts
back out with the force
of rebound.
And it's an incredibly powerful explosion. And we do have a little demonstration to give a sense for energy of the core is transmitted layer by layer through the star.
So, okay, what is this called?
This is called the Galilean canon.
Did Galileo come up with this?
I don't think so. But he dropped a lot of stuff, and we're going to drop some stuff here, right? So the idea here is that each of these balls represents a layer of a star. So this big one here is the core, and what we're going to do is we're going to drop this stack, and this ball bouncing off the base here is like the core rebounding after the star collapses.
Okay.
And then after it bounces up, it's going to hit the next layer, which is going to transmit that energy layer by layer until we get to this little guy over here. And we'll see how all the energy will be concentrated in this yellow ball and it will fly up with...
And this represents the outer layer of
the star? This is like the surface of the star. And now look, you see, if I just drop this by itself, not much happens. But if I drop the whole stack, we're
going
to see
that it goes up. Before you do that, I've been informed that this Galilean cannon right here, this is something that people have done before, but no one has ever done a Galilean cannon this tall before.
Yeah, this.
And that we have someone here from the Guinness Records people, right in the front row.
There he is, yeah.
And you're going to drop the tallest Galilean cannon of all time.
Yeah.
And we'll know that you've broken the record if that yellow ball goes through my mouth up
That's right.
Okay?
That's our target.
That's our target.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. And this, okay, so ladies and gentlemen, now representing a supernova and the rapid expansion of the outer shell of a star and breaking a world record, Mr. Brian Greene. Woo! cannon. Hypernova, the World Science Festival is June 1st through 5th in New York City. Tickets available at worldsciencefestival.com. Brian Greene, everybody. We'll be right back.